Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to build a user report in AEM with the last logged in details. AEM won't provide any out of the box feature to track the last logged in details of the users. Sometimes we may have the requirement to report the last logged in timestamp of the users for auditing purposes. Example, identify the users who is not logged in into the system for the last 1 month. This can be achieved by enabling a custom authentication info post-processor to capture the last logged in timestamp to the profile and building a custom ACS AEM Commons report to fetch the required user profile data along with the last logged in timestamp. As a first step, let us define a custom authentication info post-processor component to update the last logged in timestamp to the user profile. If you see this diagram, whenever user login to the system, the authentication handler's extract credentials method will be called. Extract credentials will perform the authentication. On successful login, extract credential method, the authentication handler's extract credentials method will invoke the authentication info post-processor method. So now you can define a custom authentication info post-processor so that will be get invoked after successful login. Now in your custom the processor, we can have a logic to update the profile, the user profile with the last logged in timestamp. Maybe we can define a custom property last logged in, and whenever the user log into the system, we can update the timestamp to that property. Then we can use either the custom report or the ACS AEM Commons report to fetch all those profile data along with this last logged in also. Let us now enable a custom authentication info post-processor that will update the user profile with the last logged in timestamp. Let me show you, let me go to Eclipse. So this is the custom authentication info post-processor I created. Component, name, then service, the authentication info post-processor dot class, then this immediate equal to true. This would be implementing this authentication info post-processor. Then there is a method, as I said earlier, post-process process. This will receive this authentication info. This will have all the authentication information, including the user ID, then request and response. Now here, I written some logic. So if the authentication info itself is null, I am just returning, so I am not performing any activity. Then you can get the user ID like this, info dot get user ID. Just I am checking for if the user ID is not blank. Then what I am doing is some logic here to update the user profile. As the first time that the property will be added last logged in, then it will get updated every time with the current timestamp. So if you see here, is the current timestamp in this format. Now here, if you see, what I'm doing is I created a kind of service user with a name custom user manager. That user is having the required permissions, modify permissions to read and modify permission for home users folder. Now whenever that user login, the timestamp will get updated into last logged in. So now let me show you the, if I go here and permission security, I already defined the service user. So now I will show you the permissions, whatever I enabled, custom user manager. If you see here, home users, JCR write and JCR read. So also I created that user mapping. So this is my bundle name, custom user report dot core, under this Apache Sling service user mapper service amendment. Then this is the service name, what I'm using in my post processor. This is my service username. Once ready, you can deploy this post processor. After that, every time the user log into the system, the timestamp will be captured into this last logged in property, the custom property of the user profile. Now maybe let me show you after login. So let me go to another window. Let me log in with my different ID, not other than admin. Okay, I'm successfully logged in. So let me now go to the CRXDE and to that particular user. Yeah, so this is my user. Then if I refresh this, yeah, if you see the date time is updated. This is my the current server time CDT. So it's updated with that. Now if I go to the admin, maybe here, yeah. If I go to the admin and go to the profile and see, it will have the last logged in timestamp. That's a different time. 21 0750, but if you see here, it's 21 28. So the user's profile will be updated with their last logged in timestamp. Maybe let us now use ACS AEM Commons user to CSV exporter to download the user details along with this last logged in property, the custom property. So I am building this demo in AEMS, say, cloud service local instance along with the latest ACS AEM Commons package, means 4.8.0. So for that, what I will do is I will go here. So go to this dot. Now if I go, you go to ACS AEM Commons. Now come down, you can find a user to CSV exporter. Now you can create exporter. This is a tag to CSV exporter. So just to create a new exporter page. Yeah, select this user to CSV exporter. Now I'm going to say user exporter. Now that's fine. Now you can leave all others. Yeah, just to click create. Now click on open. Yeah, now it's fine. So here, like one thing what you can do is you can add the custom property also. So just to click on plus, now say profile / last login. Yeah, how many custom properties you want to report it, you can do it. Then you can select only includes user by group member save, whatever, like there's different option, direct member save, indirect member save, all those things. Yeah, you can even filter by group also. And now download this user report, user CSV report. Yeah, now we can open this file. And now if you see, there is a field profile / last login. So it's having the corresponding value. The admin user last login time is 21.07. Then this specific user, it's 21.28. So other users are not logged in after we implemented this solution. This report will have all the details, including even group membership also. So all groups, direct group or indirect group, also all the users in the system. Now, maybe let us see now how to use the ACS AEM Commons report feature to build a custom report. So let me go and do that maybe. Now if I go back again, maybe you can save the configuration here for the future use. So if you go again to ACS AEM Commons, so here there is a report section, so click on that. You can build a custom report here. So I am going to build user report, add report. Now, yeah, the report is added. Just to click on edit. Now you can go into this configuration section and you edit, drag component, then click plus. JCR query report configuration, that is the only available component. Now if you edit this, you need to provide a query, then query language, then page size. Page size maybe I will go 50, then you need to provide the query. So if I go here, and this is the query I am going to, so select star from user, then it's under this node. And also I am excluding some nodes here. So CQ service, internal user, and the system users, and all those categories I am excluding, so that it will only have the custom users. So if I go and put it, yeah, that's fine. You can customize the query based on your requirement, whatever the JCR SQL query you want, you can specify here. Even you can build multiple reports also. Now this is fine, click on done. Now another one is like, I'm not going to do any search parameters here, result column. So you need to configure the result column. So for that you can select any option. I'm going to ACS Commons Report Builder text column. So if select this, it need a heading, then I'm going to say maybe given ID, maybe a given name, sorry. Yeah, given name. I will say profile / given name. Yeah, that's one property. So I will add another property, maybe the authorizable ID. So same thing. So if I go here, maybe I will go with this rep.authorizableID. So this is the user ID. Yeah, this is fine. Now maybe I will go with another one more with the last logged in property. If I go here and I say last logged in, here I can say profile : logged in. So like that, whatever the properties you want, you can add it, like email, family name, and all those things. Now this is fine. This report is ready, you configured. Now if I go back, yeah, now go open this user report. Yeah, you can see option called execute report. Just click execute report. And now if you see here, you can see those details. Only the user details are restricted. Even if you want to exclude the query anonymous admin, you can do it. Otherwise it will show you only the custom users. Now these two users have the last logged in data. So with the admin user and the local user. Now what you can do is you can download this report. The same, it will be a CSV format. Yeah, this will have the limited required data. So given like we can use the query builder to identify the users logged in into the system within a specific time. So obviously that parameter can be changed. Let me show you that. Yeah, if you see here, like you can use this values, then path, then type. Obviously, I'm going to use the relative date range. I'm saying like the property is last logged in, then like you can say the lower bound or upper bound or whatever you want. So I'm saying lower bound -1 month. So whoever like logged in within 1 month, their data will be received. So now, yeah, then like order by, then what properties you want. So you can add it here. So even this relative date range, you can change the values like seconds, minutes, hours, or day or week, month or year, whatever you want. So also you can change this, like even you can use the date range, lower bound, upper bound, even to select the data between a date range. So yeah, that's possible. So let me do this. If I go here to the query debugger. Now if I go and just copy this, yeah, now let me search this. Yeah, it will tell you like the number of users, because for my case it is only two users having the last logged in property enabled. You can adjust this value, it will change, the result will change. Now if I go to this query builder link, yeah, you can see this the JSON data. So the success, true, whatever, this fine. Then authorizable ID admin, then profile data, last logged in, family name, all those things. Then we have the other users also. Okay, the custom authentication, the post processor, even modified to add other scenarios. Example, if you want to capture the number of times the user is logging into the system. Even like if you want to capture like last 5 logins or whatever, like you can customize as required. So also like the report also can be modified to cover different scenarios. Like you want to identify an inactive user, the user not logged in within specific time, or user logged in, or like whatever. Like based on your requirement, you can change even the report also. That's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.